This is the latest machine that I've built. It's a slightly newer design and I'm actually using Velcromat for the plates. I've also moved to RepRap and in particular the Duet 2 controller, which I was sent by Ooznest to try out.
So this is what the board looks like. This is the Wi-Fi version and there's several fuses, which is a good sign, and there's lots of terminals.
I spent some time getting to know the controller, testing out the connections, learning how to program it, and working out its limitations. I decided it was good enough to keep going with, but there's room for improvement. I'll talk a little more about that later, after I've showed off my newfangled CNC machine. The machine uses SFU16 ball screws, which are size up from the previous machine, but I'm still using the same MGN12 linear rails as before. That said, I'm getting some quite impressive speeds. I'm managing over 2000 millimeters a minute with an acceleration of 100 millimeters a second. And just to compare this with the old machine, which runs at around 900 millimeters a minute with 40 millimeters a second acceleration. I've set it up with a pen tool to do some drawings. It's a quieter way to test the machine out without cutting anything, and I also like drawing with the CNC machine, which I hope to do more of. I'm also using a bigger enclosure for the Duet, with larger fans and, on the enclosure door, programmable buttons. The first moves to the stationary probe location, and the second moves to the datum position. The others are the resume job, pause job, and hard stop. All of the buttons have programmable triggers, apart from the hard stop, which bridges the reset pins on the Duet's expansion header. There's also an emergency stop or off button which kills the power to the entire enclosure. The Duet is under here. I've got larger air fans and fan on top to keep everything cool. I'm running everything through an opto-isolated series of relay modules. This thing over here is a PWM to 0 to 10 volt analog converter. Let's go back to voiceover mode so you can hear me. There's still a bit of development needed to cater the Duet for CNC use. For example, I have to use this analog converter to change the 0 to 24 volt PWM from the Duet to a 0 to 10 volt signal that the frequency drive can interpret into RPM spindle speed. There's also as of yet no spindle enable signal on the controller, but I'm assured this will be implemented in the next firmware update. And that's another thing worth mentioning. The forum is responsive, and I do get the impression that the firmware will evolve in line with its users' requirements. So the more CNC users get on board, the better it might become. I've been playing around with my Duet 2 Wi-Fi for a couple of months now, and it has won me over. There are some cons, but I'll start with the positives. The controller is easy to program. You have a system directory and, in particular, .g files which you can program with G-code from the Duet G-code library. Not everything is enabled, but it's getting there slowly. You can also write an unlimited number of macros to perform simple tasks like moving to your datum position or performing a probing cycle. I started by rewriting all the homing cycles in the system directory, and that was the first real win for me because I was able to set up dual axis homing. On this machine I've added a second y-axis proximity sensor. Having two limits on this axis allows me to fine adjust the squareness of the y-axis to the x-axis. This is a great feature for hobby or semi-pro users, as it means we're not relying on the rigidity of the gantry, which normally adds cost to the machine. It also means if something goes wrong, you're just a homing cycle away from re-squaring. The sensor at the far end is my main Y limit. The Y axis uses two drivers on the Duet, which are mapped so under normal operation, if I move along that axis, the two drivers perform together. But while homing, I utilize an M584 set drive mapping command to separate the drivers to independent limit triggers. In the web interface, you can see a U drive appear during the homing cycle, which is the second y-axis motor, which disappears after the homing cycle is completed. The Duet controller is versatile. For example, you can program different actions in case you ram your machine into any of the limits. While mine are set to hard stop, you can also have them rehome. That feature may not be necessary if you use soft limits, which set the maximum travel, but it's reassuring to know that's available. There's some other functionality which is great as well, including the M291 command, which displays a message and gives you the option to respond. You can use this command like a safety feature to prevent a macro running without a second click, or with movement keys enabled to jog the machine head before setting the work coordinate datum position, for example. You have a lot of versatility in programming with the Duet, and if you can spend a little time, you'll probably get your head around it and have it doing what you need. You can also program several input triggers, which can reference trigger.g macro files in the system directory. I've already mentioned these, but now I'll show you them in action. I have one button which moves to the probe location at the front of the machine, and another which moves to the machine coordinate x0, y0 and z-1. Note the M291 command being used to create a second click before the actions occurred when I pressed the external trigger buttons. The board is great, and the TMC2660 drivers have some great features, including the ability to set a lower holding torque to the motor while the machine is idle. This helps prevent motor heat buildup. There's also a store guard feature which can detect voltage spikes and perform an appropriate action like a hard stop if your cutting job goes wrong and the tool slips out, for example. I've still not played around with this feature, but in theory it's available. On this machine I'm using 3 amp hour motors which are being run at the maximum 2.4 amps supplied from the controller. This is 80% of the maximum current, and with a lower microstepping of 16 or 8 I've maintained a good torque. Overall, it's a really impressive bit of electronics, but I still feel it's designed for additive printing and CNC machining was an afterthought. There's a plethora of commands not recognized by the RepRap firmware, and I don't think the guys programming the board have much hands-on experience with machinists. Lucky for them. You can't use commands like G38 for probing cycles, and the G30 alternative can't perform a two-stage, two-speed cycle. Also, the normal output of G-code from a CNC CAM software can't always be read by the board. And there are no standardized post-processors for CNC use on the Duet, so you may have to write one if you decide to move to this controller. Spindle control, for example, from most CNC CAM software is written with the spindle speed first, then the M3 command to turn the spindle on afterwards, such as S2100 M3. But at the moment, I have to manually edit this to M3 2100 before running the file on the Duet. There's a few other issues as well. I've noticed that when I export G-code with interpolated curves or arcs, the resume button doesn't work in the way that it should. One way to get around that is to export G-code from your CAM file without the interpolation. But again, I've mentioned this in the forum and one of the admin programmers is looking into this. So this is a new machine, this is a new enclosure, and I am using Duet. I hope you found that interesting. What I'll do is I'll provide a link to an accompanying article that I'll write the pros and cons in a little bit more detail, and if there's anything I've missed in this video, I'll add it along there. I'm also gearing up to move to another room in the studio complex. As you may know from watching previous videos, this room suffers from some leaks and some damp issues, and I've had enough. And I think it's time to move. But the room's a lot smaller and I still have to shift a lot of this stuff upstairs once space is cleared. So this may be the last video that I film in this space, unless I decide to film the move itself, and I'm not sure if I've got the appetite to do that. Anyway, thanks again for watching, and you'll catch me whenever.